Bitcoin madness on full display as the value fluctuates by thousands in daily trading. Even as it becomes more mainstream, there is this debate over whether it's a currency or is it a bubble. Now, Overstock.com was the first major retailer to allow customers to use Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies. And, well, the bet has certainly paid off. Take a look at that chart. Overstock, by the way, that's their stock, up 300% this year. Joining me now, the CEO of Overstock, Patrick Byrne. Patrick, great having you in the studio.
Charles, it's an honor to be on your show.
You know, 2014, you say we're going to accept cryptocurrency, and everyone says this guy is absolutely nuts. What did you see then that no one else saw?
To be frank, what I saw was the thing that's underneath Bitcoin, this invention called blockchain, is going to change the world. It's bigger than the internet. I wanted familiarization with it, so I started accepting Bitcoin so I could get a team of developers to learn about it. But then we've been using that team, the blockchain team. We think we can change the world in many other ways.
Right, because you've developed different platforms within your business, right?
Right.
And so, because this is the part where people are now saying, people I never hear from, you know, relatives that never call, hey, you know, my cousin from Alabama wants to know, what's up with this Bitcoin? People are interested, but they don't understand, how do you actually open an account somewhere? How do you actually buy a cryptocurrency and what the risks are? And these are areas that you're working toward clearing up?
Yes, basically there's the conventional world that you know, and then there's this new universe being created of Bitcoin, of cryptocurrencies, of things built on the blockchain. What we have, we are developing basically a wormhole between the two universes. You know, here we have a website that 40 million unique people will come to this month. So we have a great foot in this world. We're developing these different Bitcoin and blockchain applications. We want to become the toll bridge between the two, the wormhole between the universes.
Now, there's been some pushback by Wall Street saying, hey, you know what, you guys are just trying to do this whole internet, the initial coin offering game where a lot of people jumped on a bandwagon. Some of these stocks, I think this week, a company became quote unquote Bitcoin and its shares went up 2,000%. That's raising some red flags. Again, how would people understand what's real and what's not real in this world? Because it's like the Wild Wild West right now.
It is. And I never thought I'd utter these words, but I applaud what the SEC is doing. You know, we used to live in a country where guys drove around in the backseat of the car. There's a suitcase full of stock certificates. They pull over in some farm, sell grandma, you know, fleece her out of her life savings. And so 80 years ago, this country decided that if you're going to sell securities to the public, government has to look at them, bless them, sprinkle some holy water on them, say that you're telling the truth. What people have done with a lot of ICOs is get around those rules by saying this isn't a security, and they kind of worm their way through the rules. This summer, the SEC came out and said, no more of that. These ICOs are effectively securities. You're raising money to go build a business. That's
right.
A security. What is unique, though, is by saying that, it means these tokens, these coins, are going to start having to be security. They're not utilities. It's different. So people are going to have to start issuing them and registering as securities, and they have to trade on an exchange or a trading venue that is technologically geared to handle blockchain and is SEC compliant. Right now,
and you like this whole thing. This is one rare instance you applaud more regulation.
But let me point out, we are the only one in the world. The only exchange that is SEC compliant or ATS. That's SEC compliant.
And that's the
T0?
T0.
That's one of several businesses.
Before I let you go, and they're giving me the rap signal, but people love this thing, and I got to ask, the potential. I mean, people talk about $1 million Bitcoin. Is that possible?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, the new universe is being created. It's the most important change in 6,000 civilizations of technology.
Patrick Byrne, I've always been a fan. Congratulations on your stock and being ahead of the crowd.